What an appetizer this is on a first Saturday in April where Duke and North Carolina dominate sports headlines. The two arch rivals meet on the lacrosse field here in Chapel Hill at Dorrance Field.
You can't find one better in the country.
Well, a really consistent piece of play for Duke this year has been Mike Adler between the pipes. He's been strong in cage.
Mike Adler's the anchor for the defense. He does so many things from a communication standpoint. He has a really amazing technique. Athletically, he gets in front of the ball almost in an unorthodox way. He's an amazing outlet passer. He leads to a lot of offense and fast breaks. And he really knows how to set the tempo for it. Thanks for that.
Chris Gray finds Nicky Solomon, misses wide. We backed up by Jacob Kelly, and the Tar Heels will keep it here. About 10 more seconds of the extra man. Tar Heels fourth best in the five-team ACC. Just about 35% in converting extra man opportunities. Gray hits the top of the pipe.
Looks like that'll be a reset.
Shot clock does reset when it strikes the goalie or the cage, and a new rule this year off of missed shots that stay with the offense. Shot clock resets to 60 seconds instead of the full 80. Helps speed up the tempo of the game. Back to even strength here.
If you're looking at the play right now, this is exactly what Carolina wanted, to get out, get in some good opportunities and really force the play. And, they need to do this game. It looks like they're going to slow it down 6-on-6.
Brennan O'Neill turned aside by Colin Krieg between the pipes for the Tar Heels. Krieg is pumped up. Sophomore goalie out of Long Island. One of the more unique players Joe Bresci has ever coached. Solomon fires. Adler stands tall. Strong goalie play in the opening minutes here, David.
Yeah, goalies create offense. So, if you have great goalies, you're going to have a lot of opportunities, just like you see here. Get the ball back. Generate some offense.
Antonio DeMarco, 15 and white, standout freshman, part of the number one recruiting class in the country, Mike Adler. Anything but a freshman, the graduate student who leads all active goalies in the NCAA in saves, comes up with another one.
Yeah, Adler now has three saves, but, when you look at it, you can't ask your goalie to continue that, torrid pace the entire game. So the offense...
National championship in 2013.
Yeah, 2-4, and when they went in to that tournament, they were ranked fifth.
Back-to-back impressive saves from Adler. Ryan O'Connell tried to sneak it by him. Two more for Mike Adler. He's now got six on the game. And in transition, here's Jake Caputo.
Yeah, so great goalie play is a huge psychological advantage for a team. And when you see this going on, it pumps up the rest of the players, and it makes everyone believe that, that they can perform at a higher level. So let's see if Adler can keep up that sort of, as I said before, torrid pace. But it's a good sign for the Blue Devils.
How does he keep it up if the law of averages says it's going to be tough to do?
Well, I think, again, the key is making sure the defense isn't too gassed over time. There's going to be adjustments by both teams at halftime. So, I have to say that, great goalie play like that is hard to maintain for four quarters. Let's go back at him.
288's going at it here. Krieg comes up with a save on the shot from the standout freshman, McAdory.
It was a really good stop by Carolina, trying to really make them think about the Duke Devils, think about their passes, and ultimately made them take a shot too far out.
Botched clear, Keith Boyer forces Krieg to go to his knees. Back-to-back saves by Colin Krieg. First seniors from Cincinnati. From X, here's the dangerous Chris Gray, and Adler goes to his knees again. Tell you what, if Mike Adler ends his day with those knees all scraped up and dirty, but Chris Gray's having trouble getting in the cage, Mike Adler doesn't care.
Well, I think
Duke's leader in goals this season. Just five to shoot now. Griffin Catlett in the game against a double team. Krieg stops it.
Both those Carolina players. So watch for that.
DeMarco can't dodge against Catlett playing defense as well. There's one on the doorstep. Adler comes up with a save anyway. What a first quarter from Mike Adler. Ball three. 10 seconds left in the period. Sean Lully, grad transfer from Penn. Lully past the far post. It will be Carolina possession, but just 4.5 seconds to do something here. Dario's will fling it all the way down. Bresci will come up with a shot that Adler stops just for good measure. It's number 9 for the quarter for Mike Adler, the graduate student standing on his head. And the Blue Devils keep the Tar Heels off the board in the first.
You know, both teams next time they play.
Adler, another one. Double digits with 10 saves.
It is just right now almost statistically impossible to talk about where Adler is in this game. Again, can that continue? Who knows? But it's giving the Duke team in general a lot of mojo. Yeah, which, again, you run into the law of averages. That's probably not going to happen, but it's impressive. Nine saves in one quarter.
Daniels and Brian go quick here in transition. It's Solomon from distance. It's save number 11.
And this leads to early offense, which is, again.
Dyson Williams, Reed Landon's into the game. 26 in blue, top of your screen. Freshman from Dallas who's seen extended playing time of play.
In the crease. So,
yeah, the shot number is dead even at 16. Shots on goal, 11-10 Carolina. And yet the scoreboard, the column that counts, 3-0 Duke. And it'll stay 3-0 as Adler goes down to the ground yet again.
The shirt's that prolific squash.
And how hard it is to get playing time on offense at Duke. Colin Krieg with the save on Reed Landon's shot.
Case right now, the Devils are ahead on that.
How frustrating is that for Carolina? Calling a timeout there to set something up, try and get this offense going. Instead, you turn it over. Colin Krieg does make the save on the shot by Sean Lully.
In tight, both hands, cross-handed, you name it. He can get off shots that are miraculous. So that's why they've got something going on that they're trying to key on.
Montgomery hits the pipe. Clock does reset.
Can cause you to sort of doubt yourself.
Gray from distance. Adler lays out to keep another one out of the net. That was 5-5 after the first quarter.
Yeah, I mean, I called that game, and it wound up being a real offensive. This is a goalie display that I've rarely seen.
14 saves from Mike Adler. He's 6 off his career high, David, and we still have 4.5 minutes to go in the first half.
Yeah.
Quick look in transition by Naso off the faceoff win. Krieg was ready for it. You know, you said you didn't want to exaggerate, but this is one of the best goalie performances you and I have ever seen.
Yeah, I just, he's everywhere, and he's reading things. He's almost playing unconscious, really. You know, he's reading things. A lot of goalie play is muscle memory, you know. It's like you're actually reacting and you don't know why and where, but you're there. And these goalies, you know, there's so many shots that they take, so many repetitions. All of them are simulations of difficult, you know, shots, whether it's going to be down low, right, you know, up a corner, going down to the ground. He sort of does a butterfly save sometimes, almost like a hockey goalie. I think the goalie like Adler is amazing because he's unpredictable. You know, there are certain goalies that have a certain technique and you know how to beat them. Whereas with Adler, he's actually sort of in your head as a goalie and you're wondering where his dynamic play is going to be. But to answer your question before, you know, this is a close game. You know, even though it's 4-1, like, this is a game of runs, and at the same time, you know, when you look at Adler, a lot of his shots are, I mean, saves are amazing, but watch the Duke defenders. They're on the hands of all of these shooters, right? And they're making it just a millisecond more difficult for them to get that perfect shot off.
Mike Adler with 14 saves in the first half, 6 off his career high, and a whole half still to play. Second half will begin with a face-off violation in possession to the Tar Heels. Just one goal in the first half, the fewest in a half this season for North Carolina. Not unfamiliar territory for Carolina as Tillman looks in front. Behind the back, wraparound shot again, stopped by Adler. Chris Gray tried to get fancy. Mike Adler wins the battle again. Jake Caputo in transition. Caputo fires. Krieg goes down and picks up.
Probably not a great sat for Caputo as a defensive midfielder. They're not forcing it into the middle right now. Now, that could change and they could make a bad pass, but you can see that that was a very well thought out good shot. Great save, right?
But learning when to take a shot and when he's got guys on his hands and not, that's all part of that process, right?
Right now, this is called probing. You know, they're just probing. What does it do? It wastes a little time off the clock. They're probing to see what they have. And do you have that? It's a beautiful save. Beautiful save by Krieg. He read it perfectly. The better shot probably for Robertson would be to fake and put it on the ground, which is actually his signature shot.
Time for Duke with 6-5. Up ahead, Robertson, 3-2. Can't connect with Williams. Final shot stopped by Krieg. And the quarter comes to a close to step up. And they've done that to that.
Yeah, and it was an interesting discussion we had with him because it was sort of the field general question. Who's the field general? He said the unit is the field general. There is no field general this, you know, like maybe of years past, but and again, they're playing like that. They're playing like with a song. Yeah, and it was an interesting. I saw an interview with him afterwards, one of the games, and he said, the dodge that he got.
There is the first of the day for Chris Gray. Comes with 10-12 to go in this fourth quarter. And it ties Pat Spencer for third in Division I history in career points.
Amazing, amazing goal. Amazing player. You know, you look at amazing goal, amazing player. You know, you look at him now, always finding an opportunity. His sort of low to high, but he put it right off the offside hip. Mid-range shot, and you know, he's got to get that mojo going, right? That was right offside.
Face-off win for Tyre. Adler denies him on the breakaway. 18th save for Mike Adler, 2 off his career high.
So that was a roughing call. He didn't hit him from behind. He came up on his head.
Tyre wins another face-off. Solomon will fire quickly. Adler makes the stop. That's number 19, one away from the career high. So it's a Duke team coming off a very disappointing loss to Syracuse on the road.
Make sure that they secure an ACC win in order to stay in contention, and that's how it went. You know, so it'll be a reset, I believe.
Yep, it opens. It'll be their first win in Chapel Hill since 2017, and only their second win on the road against North Carolina in the last. This edition of the rivalry goes the way of the Duke Blue Devils, behind 7 goals from Brennan O'Neill and 19 saves from Mike Adler. Duke earns a top 10 win on the road against their arch rivals.